are searching for knowledge. What a discovery. And then you're pregnant. That is real science.
Nicholas, welcome back.
Hi, it's good to be back.
And it's a great honor that former Weinberg Prize winner Professor Nicholas Ponter has chosen our university to continue his research on protein-protein interactions. And in addition to that, Professor Ponter will also lead a select number of excellent students in the Ponter Talent class.
Course.
Ladies and gentlemen, Nicholas Ponter.
We all know that scientific research boils down to one thing. At the end of the project, we know everything about nothing, or next to nothing. But there are some rare moments in one's career when you discover something which will surprise the world. When I looked at the printout of the data on that specific Wednesday morning, yes, back then, all the data was still on paper. That's when I knew we've found something. We no longer know everything about nothing, but something very important. A better understanding of how partner proteins diffuse and consequently bind each other in the cell. And if there's anything that
Sorry
I would
for
like...
interrupting, Professor, but did you really discover this yourself? I mean, did you really, personally, make this discovery, this ingenious, world-changing discovery?
Sir, if you would be so kind
as to
just
let... Did this discovery really
originate from your own mind?
Ooh, smells good. Nice. What is it?
Sautéed veal brains. You said you liked it.
For eating his mind. He thought with that.
Yeah, well, that's the question. Can a cow think?
Yeah, good question.
Philosophically speaking, yes. Scientifically speaking, no.
Well, philosophy is a science, so if it's a good question philosophically speaking, it's a good question scientifically speaking.
No. Come on. Philosophy isn't a science. No, not a real science. Philosophers boast that their scientific practice consists of asking questions, and if they happen to stumble upon an answer, they find out a trivial detail. They ask questions. Wow! Science is about knowing things. And in order to discover these things, you need to ask questions, good questions. And a good question is determined in the way it can be answered. Science revolves around the question how one can establish something as true.
Okay, so if philosophy isn't a science, then what is? Mathematics?
Of course.
Physics.
Does a bear shit in the woods?
And history?
Yes, well... No. Look, history is not reproducible. You can't control the variables. Most experiments are about knowing everything about almost nothing. You describe history. Scientific discovery is history. Physicists make history by...
So you say that a historical investigation, for example, on the resuscitation experiment, yeah, which was performed in a way that was ethically and politically incorrect, a historical investigation which I happen to have been doing for over the last year, you say that's total bullshit.
No, no, I didn't say that. It's not bullshit.
But it ain't science either.
Well, most of the university thinks it is.
Yeah, but most Weinberg Prize winners in this room think it isn't.
Well, it's how you ask your question, the way you structure your
question.
Depends
on whether it's total bullshit or not? Okay, then I shall structure my following question scientifically. Was the guy Descartes right this afternoon? And why did you not answer his question? Because I truly hope it wasn't because he was right. Oh no, you would say. He couldn't be right because it wasn't a properly formulated hypothesis. But isn't asking a question simply stating a hypothesis? Or is that getting too philosophical for you?